This is absolutely terrifying. I will be happy when it's all done without accidents. Ahoy there. Sorry my appearance, it's been a few days. We are back at our off-grid land in North Vancouver Island and we are ready to start the new season.
Recording commentaries for these videos is always a little bit of a challenge for me. So I thought that this time I would do something different. And so here's Mama.
The dreams we had when we bought this beautiful land. So far, we have focused mainly on building a cabin by the lake. But this is a new year now, and we have plans to expand. There is a cliff, higher up, overlooking the lake, and we started to clear an area that we hope to build a proper log home. This past winter was a little milder and shorter than the previous year. We wanted to visit our land as soon as possible. And Cindy seems to always give such an encouragement and lead the way. We love winter, the peace and quiet, just enjoying the walk. We notice the fallen trees blocking the driveway, the animal footprints in the snow. Oh, and now our own animal prints are added. Can you imagine? The beautiful smell of wood, the wind whispering in the trees. And we dream of the views that will open as our project continues. Well, dreaming is good, but I sometimes wish it can also do the work. We moved our kind of a garage in the box, because as soon as the spring arrives, we want to be ready to mill the logs and this shelter will protect our work. But you never know what curveball we have to face.
Today is a beautiful day. It's also a day full of disasters. So first, I killed my drone right over there. I wanted to take some nice shot of Larry working and I flew it sideways and it went into the trees and it's gone. Second, Larry broke a tooth. So apparently it's not just people who break their teeth, it's machines too. And third, they didn't quite pay enough attention and some of that construction wood is now firewood. Such are the going-ons here at Bearstone at our off-grid place in North Vancouver Island.
There are always some reminders that this is a frontier land, and all plans can change suddenly and quite unexpectedly. For now, we decided to put our log milling on hold. Let Larry finish his work with the big machine. Let him to clear the area and work his magic. It is so fantastic to watch him work. Just look at it. Wow. The amount of rock and dirt that needs to be moved, oh my, it far exceeds our expectations. That means more work, more time, and higher costs. But also the sheer appreciation of the scope of work that must be done before anything can be built in this rugged land. How did people in past manage this? I don't know. But I can see how the work translates into the love we have for this beautiful place. It all looked so simple. We thought we'll buy a piece of land, build a cabin, maybe a home. Couple of years of work, right? At every turn, our naive ideas run into the hard reality, as cold and hard as the limestone marble rock of North Vancouver Island. It constantly reminds us that this may be a long and demanding project. We will need all the help we can get. Most we learn from the local people who know how to work the land, how to build stuff, have the right tools, and we learn along the way.
We have really been fortunate in finding these professionals They are doing an amazing job. I am here the next day. The road there is, he's already filling it because we want to level it a little bit, and now he's leveling this little hump here. Cindy, come here. We are not going there. It's fascinating to watch this work. I am glad I don't have to do it with my hands.
We could watch Larry for hours. It's like a dance. Look, the strange contradiction between the power of his 20-ton excavator and the precision with which he can pick up individual rocks. And from the bird's eye perspective, it looks like maybe a dinosaur? Were they this big? This is just one person with the skills and mechanic muscle. Well, superhero.
That Larry stopped for the day, it looks like we can safely inspect and explore what's happening here. Here are the boards that he ran into yesterday, so wow, stuff happens. The big beams are still intact, that's more important. It's amazing to see how he right away starts sorting out the different types of material. The rocks based on size, and then there is all this soil that we might use somewhere. I'm sure we will. And here are smaller rocks, but I think underneath those are still those that are part of BC.
If you can't move it, it is a part of BC. That's an expression we learned early on. But when you realize that millions and millions of years ago, this used to be a warm, shallow ocean, sea creatures depositing their shells, the pressure of the layers breaking them up, cementing it with the dissolved calcite, an additional millions and millions of years, buried, heated, elevated by forces beyond imagination. That is the limestone and marble that we are walking on. It's simply amazing. It's truly mind-boggling that under all these green, soft cedar trees is a hard rock formed from gazillions of seashells. A long time ago, this may have been an ocean beach. But things change. More recently, these mountains used to be covered with a dense green secondary forest.
It's growing nicely. This will be definitely a challenge to maintain.
As soon as we bushwhacked through the property for the first time, it became clear that we will need some serious equipment. Most places were simply impossible to penetrate or even walk on.
So much forest. Oh my gosh.
Thankfully, we found help at our very first visit after we purchased the property. We heard an excavator working nearby, following the sound, and voila, we met Larry. 2 years later, I must admit that was probably the most important step in that early work. Without the heavy equipment, none of this would be possible. There would be no building pad, no trail to the lake, and no cabin. Not even Cindy's enthusiasm would have helped. But we did look for a way to strengthen our muscles. Of course, the usually recommended path, like exercise and lifting weights, was not what we had on mind. We decided to get a tractor. This way, we can handle the smaller and more delicate landscaping work. Moving it the 500 kilometers to the lake was a bit of a challenge, and we succeeded. It proved to be a very useful tool, even with some limitations. It is a lot of fun to use.
It's like some strong guy thing. It's just
macho man. Is that what we need?
It's definitely above whatever my
above your pay grade.
Oh. Sure that. Wow.
But see, we have a drop of right there. It drops off, but this area here is quite flat. So if we clear this area, it actually seems to be going a little bit up. Should I try to go there?
Sure, don't kill yourself.
Okay. This should definitely be wide enough for us to build here. I guess that will be our plan, to clear this off and continue working with the builder. Larry came to do some work with the excavator on the neighbor's property, so it's a little noisy here. But here is the view back down where I came from. And here is where I am headed.
Without the excavator, we would never even consider going up the cliff and clearing a patch of relatively flat land high up on the cliff. But with the large excavator here, Larry willing and available to work, all we had to do was to survey the area, mark it, and watch the transformation. Now, this is gardening, just in the forest. And regular tools will not do.
I can't believe that only 3 months ago I was bushwhacking here and marking the boundaries of where I thought the path would be.
Working with Larry has been a real eye-opener and also real joy. His ability to read the forest and navigate this rugged terrain is just amazing. Some of our neighbors here at the lake also helped us with some work. Too small for the big machine, but too big for our tractor. We are so fortunate to be in this friendly and helpful community. We were more than happy to exchange their work for some of our wood, which we seem to have more than we can ever process. Of course, our little tractor, the Krtek, did much of the smaller tasks, including digging the foundation. And it continues to be such a fun machine to use for many of the smaller jobs. Our tractor is a tiny baby compared to the big machine. Hiring this 20-ton monster was not cheap, but it opened many new possibilities, like moving huge boulders to the entrance to the trail that lead to Bearstone, or repairing road erosion.
Recently we found that this part of the road is really soft and it's washing off, it's eroding. So I'm taking advantage of Larry working upstairs. Upstairs is somewhere over there behind the trees. That's where Bearstone is. He already brought the load here and he will fix up the road. That should be interesting. He is a very smooth operator. You can see the years of experience when he is working. But I'm still a little worried that, some rocks might roll down. I will be happy when it's all done without accidents and that sort of thing. Better be gentle. The cabin is right here. This is absolutely terrifying. But he is amazing. Beautiful.
were seriously surprised seeing the amount of material dug out of the top of Bear Stone. It definitely exceeded our expectation. As Larry continues working for the next several days, and as the rocks and soils are piling up, we looked for more opportunities, maybe to build trails to areas of our land that are currently not accessible. Look at the perfect fill. It would be used so well in these areas, and we do want to be able to walk on our land. Agreed on a good deal. Over the course of summer, Larry would build a trail connecting Bear Stone and a cabin. It would substantially shorten the travel between the two sites. Even though they are only about 100 meters apart, we have to take a long detour through other properties. But with our trail, it will make our life and work moving tools and materials much, much faster. The plan was simple. Little did we know that extreme drought and an accident would wreak such a havoc into our plans. All the work had to suddenly stop. We ended up with three huge piles of rock right in the middle of what we thought would be the center of our milling work. There was now no way to avoid it. On the positive side, it allowed us, maybe forced us, to concentrate fully on finishing the cabin. But let's leave that for another video. Thank you for watching, and until the next time, we are off-grid bound.